A very good morning everyone. Now this is the second video wherein we are learning about the Edmodo class, how can we create the class and how we can add various assignment and quiz along with the poll to our classes. Now if you see on the first page, on this left hand side you can see that I have two classes which I have created, the FMI class and the Shikha's class. So anything that I am posting to either of these classes is appearing on my home page, but you can easily identify as to which material or which message has been posted to which class. So if I go to this particular message and I just browse here, I can see that this message has been shared with Shikha's class, which is my second class, this one, and this message has been shared with FMI. So you can easily identify as to which message has been shared with which of the class. Now you can also change your profile. This is the picture that I have added. You can just click here and in your page there must be a button with the name of upload photo. So if you are using it for the first time, you will have to upload your photo. If you like it, then you can do that. Now let us see how we can add various material to the classes. For that I am selecting Shikha's class and I will go to this plus tab. Now as soon as I go to plus tab, it asks me for four options. It asks me whether I want to create a new assignment or I want to load an existing assignment. So if any teacher who has been using this Edmodo for a long time and has given the assignments in the past, the same assignment can be again loaded here into the new class. So you can also load an existing assignment. The same is with the quiz also. You can also load an existing quiz. But let us learn how to create a new assignment and how to create a new quiz using Edmodo. So first let us go to create assignment. And we need to give the assignment title. Let us give it money market reforms and let us give the instructions. Write at least 5 important reforms, and along with that you can also add certain attachments. You can add any file that you want your students to read before attempting this assignment. You can also add a link if you want that any link from the YouTube or from your browser should be here. You can also add that, or you can also add something from the library. This we'll also see today, how we can add any material from the library. Now here I can just click on the assign button, but if I don't think that this assignment is perfect, then I can also close this, so the assignment would be deleted. Let us click on assign button. And to which class you want this assignment to be assigned, whether you wanted to assign it to Shikha's class or you wanted to assign it to FMI or you wanted to assign to any particular student. So that option you can also select, but as I have already selected Shikha's class, so that particular class is already coming here. I can also select a due date. I want my students to complete this assignment by 15th of June, so I have selected that. And I can also click this. So when I check this, it means that I will lock this assignment after 15th of June, so that no student would be able to submit any assignment after the due date. I can also schedule it for later. When I schedule it for later, it means that the assignment won't be posted right now, but it would be fixed that the assignment has to be assigned on any particular date. For right now, let us click on this assign. Now the item has been sent and it will appear on the home page. Let us go and see where it is coming. We need to reload this. Because it's necessary to sync it, it's necessary to refresh the page so that the students are also able to view the assignment. Now you can see that the assignment has come up here in the home page, the money market reforms, Right, and here we can see that it has been shared with my second class, which is the Shikha's class. Now let us go to this calendar that you can see on the topmost right side. When we click on this, this is the Edmodo planner. So it will tell us, is there any assignment or test or quiz that has been scheduled in the past week or in the coming week. So it gives us a plan. So you can see here that for 15th June, the money market reforms assignment is due for Shikha's class, and for Tuesday there are two assignments that are due for the other class. So it can give you a quick review of the due assignments that are there for this coming month. Let us go back to our class. Let us go to Shikha's class, and here let us click on this plus button again, and now let us see how can we create a quiz. So click on the create quiz button, and in this quiz we have these two sections. The first section asks us about the quiz details, and the second thing asks us about the questions that we need to ask in the quiz. So in the quiz title we can just ask related to insurance, and in the instructions we can write read all the material before attempting the quiz. Right, so after this we can go to quiz questions. Now when I come to quiz questions, we can see that there are six types of questions that we have. We have the true false type, multiple choice, short answer, fill in the blanks, matching, and multiple answer. So these are the various options that we have. Let us click on true false and write any question here. LIC is the biggest reinsurer in the country. As we know that the answer is no, right, because GIC is the biggest reinsurer in the country. So the correct answer is false. We can also increase or decrease the points here, and next we can add a new question, and you can see here on the right hand side all the changes are being saved automatically. So the second question, I can add matching, right? So I can write here LIC and GIC. So in the answers I know that LIC is for life and GIC is for general insurance, right? And this I need to close. So I can increase the marks again to 5. So these are my two questions, and these answers won't appear on the students tab because it will automatically shuffle when it is appearing as the question on the students desktop or the laptop. Let us see its preview. So for that, click on preview button. Right, so this is the preview that we have. You can see that the answers are not appearing here, and the automatic time limit for the quiz is 1 hour. So the timer has started. This is the next question. So when the students are attempting it, they need to drag the correct answer and they need to bring it here. And as you can see here that it has automatically changed. Okay, so we'll exit the preview and we will assign the quiz to the students. Again, assign to Shikha's class, and we can select any due date. Let us keep it for today itself and lock after due date. Randomize questions. We can add to gradebook and show results to students upon completion. We just assign this quiz. Now we have assigned and it is appearing here. Now let us go back to our library, because this is a very important tab that we have. Now what do we mean by library? Library is where we can keep all our material at the beginning of the session itself, and whenever we want to post any material to the student, we can simply take it from the library and we can post it. So there is no need of searching the material again and again. At the beginning of the session, everything can be scheduled at one place, which is the library. and this library is not visible to the students until and unless I assign that particular thing and I post it to the students' class. So let us try something. In the library, go to New and go to File Upload. So I can choose various options. I am choosing a file. Let me select any image. You can select various options. I am trying with the image. So as soon as I enter one image, I go to add files. Now you can see that it is here in the library. Okay, so if I go back to home, now here in the home tab, you can see there are two things. You can attach files and images from your device, or you can add from library. So this is the second. Similarly, if I go to any class, let us go to this class, and here you can see that add from library. So here also you can select this attach to post, and you can type for your students, read more about insurance. So I will click on post. Now here it has been shared with this particular class, while in the previous it was shared with my connections or with other teachers on the Edmodo. So it's your choice whether you want to share any material from the library to your students or to other teachers on the Edmodo. Now one more thing we can see here is we can also create a poll. For that, where it is written start a discussion on the home page, as soon as you click your browser, this box appears, and here we have this create a poll. So sometimes we want to take a poll from the students, so we can ask, are you enjoying the session? So we can type yes and no, and we can post the poll to the students. We can add more options also here, that is also possible. Similarly, we can also type a wellness check, right? So we can just click on wellness check, and these options are already here. We can simply post it, and the students can click on this wellness check, and you will get to know about the well-being of the students. So these are some good features of Edmodo, in which you can have a flipped classroom along with your students. Now let us see how we can grade the students. So if you want to see a particular assignment, you can just go down where you have put in your assignments, and you can click on that also. Suppose this was the money market reform. This is one way you can click on this, and you can see view assignment, and you can see that none of them has turned in because I didn't had any students in this particular class. Or you can click on the classes and you can go to progress. Let me show you my other class in which I have two students, so I can show you. So here go to classes, go to progress, and here you can see these are the assignments, and you can grade your students here. They haven't been graded because I haven't yet checked their assignments. So now if after checking their assignment you want to give them marks, you just click against this. It is 10 out of 10 and 9 out of 10. So you can give them the marks like this, and you can also, there is one more feature, you can also export these marks from here. So you can click on the export button and all your marks would be exported in a Excel file. This is the additional feature of your Edmodo. So, and if there are any notifications, you can see it from here, just like we have on our social media, Facebook and everything. Any message that the student has written can be seen from these messages. So you can learn more about this Edmodo, and hope you'll enjoy this flipped classroom version with your students. Thank you so much.